Hello and welcome to all of my fantastic grade 3 and 4 students and anybody else who may be watching today. Today's lesson and next week's lesson is going to be on bucket drumming. For the lesson, you will need a pair of sticks and a bucket. Now, there are alternatives, guys. Okay, you can get some dowel, you can get some old wooden spoons, you can get some chopsticks, you can get some twigs. Here's one I prepared earlier from outside. There are alternatives to drumsticks. You don't need drumsticks. If you're really keen, go and buy a pair of drumsticks or order a pair of drumsticks online. They're about 10 bucks each. Okay, you'll need a bucket. It would be fantastic if you had a bucket like this one, the good old Bunnings special, okay, with a rim on the outside, okay? A lot of you might have those little plastic buckets around the house. They're kind of okay. If that's all you've got, then that's fine. You know what? I've seen people play on big cardboard boxes as well. Just don't bash them too hard because I'll fall apart. But you guys can be creative. You should have got some information preparing you for the lesson today, so you need the sticks and the bucket. Be creative. If you haven't got anything sorted, you're going to need that before we start the lesson. So perhaps pause now and go and get your stuff organized and come back. Okay, pause your video now. Welcome back, everybody. Okay, so let's start with how we hold the sticks. So really, it's just like holding a knife and fork at the dinner table, okay? Using your manners, cutting things up, blah, 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 blah. Off you go. So thumbs at the side, pointers on the opposite side, and your sticks should be straight with your arms like that. And then when we come back to the bucket or whatever we're playing, we should have a little V happening. So don't have your sticks parallel like that. Have a little V created with your sticks, okay? Let's talk about the surfaces of the that we're playing today and next week. So we're gonna be playing on the floor. We're gonna be playing on the side of the bucket, the top of the bucket, and the rim. Also, sticks in the air as well. There's a couple of patterns that I'll show you in a second that are going to be in the song today and next week. Okay, or one of the songs today and one of the songs next week. Okay, so let's just do this. Let's get a bit of a beat happening here on the floor. Okay, so obviously you need to be kneeling on the floor. So we're just going to do this. 1, 2, 3, 4 with both hands at the same time. 4 and 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1, 2, 3. Now go to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4. So if you guys have got those little plastic buckets that you might find, they'll rock around all over the place. So you might need something to kind of stabilize them. Okay, let's go to the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. And let's go to the rim. 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, keeping your sticks in that V shape, not parallel. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now click your sticks together after 4. 1, 2, ready, go. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Now stop. Okay, so a little bit of a warm-up there. Well done, you guys. We've spoken about how to hold the sticks. We've spoken about the surfaces. Let's talk about some sticking patterns, okay? I've got to remember to do this in reverse because it's going to be mirror image for you guys. So my right will be your left. Okay, so hold up your left hand. Hope I got this right. Hold up your right hand. Oh, that's hard to do. That's going to test my brain. Okay. What I want to do is a thing called a single stroke roll. And it's one stroke on the right, one stroke on the left. Have a look at my V. Beautiful. Not parallel, V. Thumbs at the side. Pointers on the opposite side, three remaining fingers under the stick. Nice loose grip, okay? So let's do that single stroke roll. So it's just right, left, right, left. Go right, left, right, left. Keep going. Okay, beautiful. Try it on the rim. Try it on the side. Don't hit it too hard, your bucket will go everywhere. Try it on the floor. Okay, beautiful, well done, guys. Now, That was a single stroke roll, a single stroke on each stick, on each hand, right, left, etc. What do you think a double stroke roll is going to be? Yes, you guessed it. Two on the right, two on the left, okay? Starting on the top, let's do two rights, two lefts after four. One, two, ready, go. Right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left. Don't forget that V. Nice relaxed grip on the rim. Right, right, left, left. On the side, right, right, left, left. On the floor, right, right, left, left, right, right, left, left. Okay, so how are you guys going so far? Awesome, pretty straightforward. Basically, all we're going to do now is talk about a couple of patterns, and then we're going to play along to two songs, all right? So let me just have a look at our notes there. Done that, done that, done that. Perfect. Okay, I want to get you guys to do this. Floor, top, stick, stick, stick. Floor, top, stick, stick, stick. Floor, top, stick, stick, stick. Floor, top, join in. Floor, top. Floor, top, floor, top, floor, top. Okay, that little pattern there is going to be in both of the songs today, okay? So I'll just yell out, okay? I'll just yell out, do that pattern, or I'll yell something out. I don't know what it is yet, but we'll work it out. You'll see what I do anyway. Okay, now I want to do some call and response before we finally start our songs for today. So we've done this before. Some, it might be new to some people. It's where I play a rhythm and then you repeat it back to me. Okay, so. That was just a warm up, okay? But the difference with this is, you know, we're not playing just one drum, like a hand drum behind me, wherever it is, where we just play one sound, or one surface, I should say. It's different surfaces, so you need to look at what I do. For instance, I might go, and then you play it. I might go, and then you play that. So you got to watch really carefully. I won't make it too hard, you guys, but I will next week. Okay, here we go. Me first, then you. One, two, my turn, go. Now you. Now me, okay. How'd you go? Awesome, well done. All right, we're gonna do our first song. It's My House by Flo Rida. You guys simply watch and listen and copy exactly what I do. Okay, everything ready to go? All right, let's rock. Get and roll.
Open up the champagne, pop. It's my house, here we go. Come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door.
Okay, we got that pat.
Welcome to my house, baby. Take control now. We can't even slow down.
good work, guys. Well done. Okay. Song number two, coming right up. Okay, well done, you guys. Here's song number two, which you guys will know pretty well, I think. Pretty popular song at the moment. So here we go. Watching my patterns. We're going to do that same pattern in the chorus of the song, okay? You've just done forming music, so you should be able to recognize the chorus. Okay, here we go, guys. Watching. Guys, a little decrescendo in the last bit where we gradually get softer. Well done. Hope you enjoyed bucket drumming today. You have some homework to do. You guys need to get onto my YouTube channel, which you're already on, so you may as well just do this now. And you need to look up bucket drumming song number one, okay? And I want you to do that routine with that video. I'll see you guys next week for some more bucket drumming. See you guys.